Over the years, I have been fortunate enough to be able to participate in the Webster Art Fair. One of the first things about the Webster Art Fair I love is the setting. I mean, you're in this beautiful grassy area, you know, right, you know, by the park. The nice thing is like, you know, they really care about the artists, and I love that. And the community comes, which is always fun. On Friday night, you can see everybody that lives around there has come down to the park, which is, it's kind of cool. Been showing my paintings there. Last year I did a double booth. I showed both my mixed media paintings. It's always nice to have wine. They have food trucks, which is always good food. And then I think the best of it is just really, there's just a community, you know, you just know that they're there and I like it. So one of the things about going to an art fair, you know, as somebody that's coming by, is if you really love an art fair and you love an artist, the best thing you can do, which compliments the artist and helps your house, is like, you know, when you buy artwork, you're supporting an artist, you're supporting a small business. And then also the best thing is like when you get home, you have original art, you know, because people will come into your house and they'll be like, where did you get that? I haven't seen that. And they'll be so excited. And then you can smile and say, yes, you know, it's original artwork. A successful art fair is an art fair that has great artists. And to keep great artists, there is business involved in it. You know, if you're buying, if the art fair has a lot of people buying art, the great artists keep coming. You know, there's always so many different price ranges in an art fair because some people get really worried that, oh, I won't be able to afford it. I'm telling you this right now, at every art fair, most people can afford something there. If you have a question, ask the artist. There really is, you know, no, if you don't understand it and you want to know more, go ask the artist, because most artists, I can't say all, but most artists love to talk about their work. Is once I finish painting the painting, I take it to my garage and I lay it flat, and then I glaze it and then I blow torch it. And that's what's giving that super high shine. And you can still, if you touch the piece, it still has a give to it, which is kind of cool. So that's one of the questions I get. But that piece isn't finished, so I'm working, you know, on two. So I never know how many hours it is, but I can tell you how many hours I spend in studio. If I am not on an art show, I am in studio. I'll be back here in studio all day. And sometimes at night I come into studio. I'm here often. We counted it once when my daughter was doing a business class and I was roughly in studio 70 hours that week. I'm in my studio a lot, but I don't feel like I'm working right now. This is fun. So I'm playing. I get paid to play. Someone will come in and they'll tell me that their son or daughter, you know, loves art, is thinking about art. And I always love that because nothing is more exciting for me than to see some kid excited and want to do art. And I'm gonna give the answer I always give to every parent and every child. Take business classes. I hate doing paperwork. But last year, I can use last year as an example because it's best for me to remember that tax year. I paid and collected sales taxes in 17 states. That is an amazing amount of paperwork to do. There's a lot of different things. And there's also knowing, you know, like if I go travel, because right now I'm currently planning a couple shows in Florida. Well, when I'm traveling, I'm driving there, which is going to cost me about $600 in gas. Then, you know, and then I have flights coming home because I do have a daughter still at home, so I fly home in between shows. So there's a lot of little expenses people don't think about. And so sometimes when you buy a piece of artwork, you know, a lot of it is about the art and the creativity, but then sometimes there's a background behind it. You know, how much do the booth fee cost? Spend a lot of time in hotels because I travel to so many shows. I do shows all the way from up to the Hamptons, down to Key West, Houston, Chicago, lots of places. So a lot of times I'm in hotels and I end up writing random little notes or doodles on the hotel pads. And so these show up in my mixed media, just kind of little fun little pieces. I dream of these things in my sleep. And so it's so fun to be able to create and put it on paper. You know, I have a good life. You know, I like to think always in the positive. So, you know, for me, looking at bright colors makes me happy. I did not finish my degree, which has been my regret. And so I've been preaching to my daughter and my son and all their friends to go finish college before you quit, like I did. But I had started going to school for chemical engineering. So I have a very strong mathematic background. And so I think a lot in mathematics and shapes and stuff, which has been fun because you can kind of see the mathematics in that, but my mixed media, I'm really pulling it in. When I'm in studio, I'm just at peace. I don't feel like I'm working. I mean, I could be here all day and all night and not think of it, which is always good, because it's, you know, to have a life that you never feel like you're working is pretty darn good. How I actually sell my work, because, you know, you do have to make an income, is I do art fairs across the United States. I love doing the art fairs because, I have galleries that carry me, and that's great, and it's wonderful. And then you get a check here and there in the mail. But I never meet who buys my work. And for me, my work is so much of me that it's kind of fun to meet the people that buy it. I've made a lot of good friends along the way, and it's kind of fun to, you know, run into somebody that's bought a piece and, you know, and like, hey, we still have it, we still love it, you know, I'm so glad to see you again. And they had stars in them, and she bought one for each one of her sons because they were allowed to go to the art fair to pick out a piece of artwork for them. And they both chose my booth, and she was like, are you sure you guys both want the same thing? And they both said yes. Well, recently that mom had another baby girl, and she's just slightly, I think, a year and a half. And her sons came to her and said she needs a star in her room too. And so just recently I got contacted about that, and it was kind of fun because I painted a star just for their little sister to go with their room. And I don't paint in pink. That's not my color, but I painted a really cool magenta pink star to go with her room. And so everybody was excited. Those are the things that, you know, it's exciting. You know, it's fun for me. It's just part of being people's lives. And you can't beat that. The one thing that I do is I only do juried art fairs. And for somebody that's not familiar with what that means that I actually have submitted slides of my of a few pieces of my artwork, and I submit slides of my booth. Because in a juried art fair, they're looking for a professional artist. They're looking for, that everything's up to par and professional. What happens is you're competing against a whole bunch of other artists. The best way I explain it is I'm in about the only job that I actually pay to be interviewed. So I pay to get, you know, to have all my artwork go through a jury. And, some shows, depending on the size, will have, you know, they may have 500 to 3,000 applications. Webster Groves is very good about that. They also, they have a jury system. And I'm not sure how many applicants they get, but they get a really good selection of artists that come and apply to the show. And just because you apply doesn't necessarily mean you'll be in, which is always kind of hard because, you know, you always want to be accepted. But it also, what the good thing about that is it keeps you on your game. You know, it keeps you trying to make the best work you can make, because if you're not making, you know, really great work, you're not going to get it in the show. What's really good for the people coming to the show is they can know that the art that there is there really, you know, cared about their work, and that there is a professional jury that decided their work was good enough to be there.